notes get longer every time. I'm like, oh, I made it. So good evening. My name is Mike. I'm actually going through yoga teacher training right now. I should be finished in September. And our friend Brandy usually does yoga and bowl baths on a Monday and a Wednesday. But she's not feeling well, so we are taking care of her practice for her and offering peace, love, joy, happiness. So it continues, because, you know, kind of whether it's a torch or a cup, and, you know, you're filling up somebody's cup or you're lighting other people's torches, you know, you've got to keep that light or the fluid going, so we're all, like, at least together and saying, ah, it's not that bad, because at least we have each other, you know. So if whatever, something's bothering you, if you can, for the next hour and a half, just let it go. You know, it'll be there when you come back an hour and a half, but this is a good time to take care about yourself. You know, a little physical with the yoga that we're about to do, which is Bikram based. So we're already in a hot room, so we're already set. That's what I always loved about it. You go to a hot yoga room and you live in San Antonio or you live in Las Vegas and you're like, it's really not that hot. I just came out of water. So it's a nice kind of room that you're acclimated to. So, and a warmed up muscle is harder to pull. And saying that, if you feel something's a strain or you can't, you know, nothing wrong with laying down Savasana, laying down Child's Pose, taking a knee, just going to stand here and breathe for a little bit. You know, whatever you need to do. In fact, you could just lay down the entire time and do absolutely nothing, and you would still get the benefits of being here, being around people, and then just being peaceful. So, if you allow me to take you for a ride for about 45 minutes, and then when you're nice and warmed up, you can sit down, lay down in whatever position you want, and Shanda will grace us with her vibrations, and we can watch clouds fly by. Sun go down and be a really nice day. So we'll begin with pranayama deep breathing, and I'll demonstrate just in case you guys haven't seen it. So you'll be in standing position, your feet will be together, interlock your fingers, put your knuckles on your throat, and you'll inhale for a 6 count, and then you'll exhale, put your head back gently, out your mouth. Shoulders together, keep your legs straight, spine straight, chest up, put down. And what this does is, one, starting off with a breathing exercise, it focuses you concentration, but it also warms up the inside of your body by just breathing and bringing that air in nice and slow, expanding your lungs, getting ready for what you're about to do. So if everybody's ready, if you'll come to anywhere on your mat that you feel happy with. I've known instructors, come to the center of your mat. Come to the center of your mat. So, I'm not like that. Wherever you want to be, it's your mat, it's your time. Enjoy. Pranayama deep breathing. Bring your hands together, palms to touch, and inhale. 1, 2, 3. Expand your lungs. 4, 5, 6. Exhale. Out your mouth. Lift back, push your spine up, 3, 2, 1, inhale, keep your knuckles underneath your chin, exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale through your belly, inhale, 1, 2, 3, go for deeper, lungs more, 6, exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale, it's making you dizzy, okay, get that good stretch, open up your lungs, concentrate, exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale, bring your head back down, elbows come up, 3, 2, 1, exhale, forceful, out, breathe everything out, than the last one. More air in. Suck it in. Exhale. Drop your head back gently. Inhale. Deepest one so far. Exhale. Make that H-A ha sound. They say it's the best way to exit out everything's bothering you. Inhale. Last one. Deepest one. Inflate your lungs like you're gonna be a balloon and fly away. Exhale. Let it all out. Breathe out. Push your stomach in. Suck it in. Push. Side, feet together, eyes forward, bring your arms up over your head, palms together, interlock your fingers, release your index. You want to keep your biceps in line with your ears, chest up, hips forward, upper body back, stretch up out of your waist, and bend your body right and left, right and left. You don't necessarily have to keep your knees locked, just as long as they're kind of straight. Please come back to the center and stop. Push your hips forward, chest up, arms back. Weight in your heels. Press your feet down, lift your thighs up, lock your elbows. Chin up, concentrate. Stretch up out of your waist as high as possible and bend your body to the right. Push your hips to the left to create a stretch on your entire left side. Breathe normally in and out of your nose. Come down and push. Hips forward, upper body back more. Open your chest. Push your left hip forward, right shoulder forward to get everything in one line. Push your hips to the left, stretch your body down to the right. Come down and push and push. Left side. Stretch about your waist as high as possible and bend your body to the left. Push your hips to the right. Create a stretch on your entire right side. Just keep breathing normally in and out of your nose. Hips forward, upper body back more. Open your chest. Breathe normally. Come down and push and push. And push. Inhale, slowly come back up, stop in the middle. Take a deep breath. Stretch your spine up towards the ceiling. Gently drop your head back. Just like this. Try and touch the fence behind you. Me. Push your hips forward. Chest up. Arms back immediately. Go for it. Try to bend yourself into a U. Keep breathing normally, in and out of your nose. Push your hips forward, push your thighs forward, push your stomach forward. Lean back, lower back, middle back, upper back, way back, look back, breathe. Again, push your thighs and hips forward. One more stretch. Slowly come back up, stop in the middle, be still, breathe. Bend your knees, suck your stomach in, put your hands on the floor, backward bending. I'm sorry, hands to feet. We should sit backward then. Relax your neck, your shoulders, your head down. Grab your heels from behind, little fingers touching. Step on all fingers of each hand, pull on your heels. You want your stomach on your thighs, your chest on your knees, your face on your legs below your knees. Try to lock your knees. Push your knees straight. Pull everything into the center of your body. Push your wrists together to touch. Breathe. Lock your knees. Keep pulling, keep stretching. The object of pulling is stretching. Never stop pulling, never stop stretching. Pull, lock your knees. Weight in your toes, lock your knees. Bring your arms together, suck your stomach in, slowly come back up. Arms over your head, arms down by your side. Breathe. Awkward pose. Right foot 6 inches to the right, or chest width, whatever works for you is comfortable. And bring your arms up, bring them down and then up, so that way it keeps your shoulders down and you get the better stretch out of it. So bring your arms up 90 degrees, like you're holding a box, and it's not gonna fall. Immediately suck your stomach in, go down on the tops of your feet, into the chair. Your butt back, your arms forward, you're counterbalancing with your push and your pull. Breathe. Come down a little bit lower, come down in the chair, straight back, chest up. Arms level. Breathe in and out your nose. Relax. Come up. Keep your arms there. Come up on your tippy toes as high as you can, like a ballerina. When I say go down, you'll go down immediately. High on your ankles, knees and thighs up as high as possible. 1, 2, 3, go down. Straighten your back. Reach with your arms. You want your back like it's against the wall. Straight, 90 degrees. Push higher on your heels. Higher on your knees. Breathe. Inhale, come back up. Feet down. Bring your legs, keep your arms up there. Bring your arms a little bit closer. Bring your knees to touch. And when you go down, you're gonna go down for a 10 count. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep your back straight. Keep your arms straight. Keep your stomach stuck in. Breathe. You're doing great. Slowly come back up. Arms at your side. Feet together. Breathe. Eagle. Arms over your head. Bring them down, cross at your elbows, right arm is underneath. I always get this, I'm like, what? So for me, like I'm told I have a big chest, I have issues with, so I lean a little bit forward, lock my elbows, and I can, this is as far as I can go. The goal is to have your, below your nose, your fingers, but you know, maybe next lifetime. So come down, keep your back straight, into the chair. Bring your right leg over your left leg, try to cross like two ropes. If you can bring your foot on the back of your calf, that's perfect. If you can't, just aim and push as far back as you can. Try to keep your back straight. Breathe. A little bit lower in that chair, straighten your back. Sucking that stomach. Slowly come back up. Leg down. Arms back up. Recross. Left under the right this time. Really pivot at that the elbow. Sit down. Straight back. Lower in the chair. Bring your left leg over. You can. If you have to put it down on the ground, kind of in a curtsy squat, whatever works. Whatever your practice or your body says, I can do this today. That's all yoga is. It's what can you do today, not what somebody else is doing, not what, you know, I did yesterday. What can I do today? Slowly come back up. Arms down by your side. Get a drink of water. fall, it's okay to fall out of it. Just hold what you can. All right? Left leg, solid like a lamppost. Interlock your fingers. Bring your leg up. Reach with your grip underneath your toes. Keep your hands together. Straighten your back and bring your leg out. Hey, I've gotten a little bit better. I can, you know, hold it and go. Whatever you can do. Breathe. Hold. Lock the left leg that's down. Bulldog determination. Hold it. Slowly come back out. You can wipe your hands on your shorts or whatever you got. Other leg, left leg, up. Right leg, solid like a lamppost. And kick out your leg. Suck in your stomach. Breathe in and out your nose. Look at a spot in front of you. Doesn't matter if you fall out of it, just get back in. Try again. Good motto. Now slowly bring it down. Bring it down to your side, arms together. Breathe. Standing boat pulling pose. Put your hand out at your side, 90 degrees. Bring your leg up. Grab at your ankle. Inside of your ankle, fingers and thumb together. Bring your left arm up over your head 90 degrees. Knees together. Charge. Aim forward. Stretching with your arms, kicking with your legs. Kick with your legs. The more you kick, the more you'll stay. You can hold this forever. Cool. See if you can pull your leg up a little bit higher. You're trying to imagine it behind your head. Come back up. Put your leg down. Other side. Left arm out, 90 degrees. Grab your ankle with all your fingers on the inside. Push your knees together. Arm up. Charge. Five. In fives, what can't I do in fives? I only gotta do this for 5 seconds? Okay, just 5 more seconds? Okay, just keep kicking, pulling, stretching. 5, 4, 3, 2. There you go, 1. Very good. Come back up. Arms together. At your side. How's that feeling? As long as you breathe, that's all that matters.
Are you waiting for the shoulders?
Yeah. Shoulders
and I think of life, like as long as you're breathing, as long as I'm alive, I have a purpose. So, and a person with a purpose cannot be destroyed, because are you going to let anybody get in the way of you doing what you really want to do? So, just keep breathing, just keep moving, just keep swimming. Just keep swimming. Anyone? Nobody? All right. Alright, come to the back of your mat, arms together, balancing stick, right foot out, left foot pointed. When I say go for it, you're going to make yourself straight like a T, pushing and pull both directions. Ready? Go! Bring your leg up, look forward, try to be a T. You're trying to elongate your spine. Stretching forward, pulling backwards. Legs going back. Arms forward. And come back down. Now switch legs. Bring your other leg forward. Big step. And charge. Bend at your waist, at your hip. If you can, point your toes backwards. Stretch and pull. Exact opposites. You want your belly button flat Come back up. Arms down by your side. Three. Come to the back of your mat again, facing this way. Take a large step, 4 feet. Bring your arms parallel with the ground. And when you go down, with your hands underneath the outsides of your feet, your toes are on, or your feet are on your fingers. The first stretch part of this is the backs of your legs. The second part is the lower spine. And what you're doing is you're now pulling yourself down. The goal is to put the forehead on the floor. If you can't get there, don't worry about it. As long as the backs of your legs, you feel that strain on your hamstrings and your quads in the back, just pull, just keep breathing. I found myself in this position with sweat filling up my nostrils and I'm going, I can't breathe, but I can breathe, and I'm just small little breaths. Release, come back up. Turn your right foot forward. Your left foot at a 45 degree, come down into warrior two. From warrior two into triangle. So bring your arm down. You can plant it in between your toes. If not, up is good. If you have to lay on your knee, that's good too. As long as you're in a position, open your chest. Your upper arm is reaching back. Your head is looking back over that shoulder, getting that good breathe. Come back up, turn your right foot back into the there, turn your left foot out, come back to the left side, and go down into warrior two. Bring your arms down into triangle. Two hips in one line, your chest is open, your head is looking up, you're breathing. Slowly come back up, turn your legs forward, bring your feet together, arms by your side. Tree pose. So you can, well, we can go back to basic this way, I guess. I did that so you didn't end up stepping on rocks and stuff. So tree pose. You want to bring this as high as you can. This as far as you can get, and that's as far as you can get. But you want your sole up and your knee down gently. So be nice to yourself. So lock your left leg, bring your right leg up. Soles of your foot up, knee down and gentle. If you can let go and bring your right hand to the center of your chest and hold, and your left hand to the center. If you can't, just hold what you got. Breathe. Your standing leg should be locked. Ooh, yeah. Back down, feet to the floor, hands by your side, lay down in Savasana. So that was the standing series. We're now going to do the ground series. How was that for everybody?
Good.
I like my yoga to wear me out. Sleep. they say Savasana is the hardest pose because most Americans or Western civilized people can't take not moving. So just lay here, eyes closed, arms at your side, or whatever you makes you comfortable, feet open, breathe. Leaving your left leg on the ground, calf flat, interlock your fingers, bring your right knee up and out on the outside of your ribcage. If there's a little dude in the way, then if you can't do that, oh, I was talking about your baby. The goal is to get your knee to your shoulder. Breathe, flat back. Back down, arms at your side, the other leg, grab it below your knee, pull it into your shoulder, out to the outside of your rib cage. There you go. Yeah. Bring it back down. Both legs up. Grab your elbows around your knees. See if you can pull it in. The goal of anything is to at least have your head on the floor and your back flat. Someday your entire spine will touch the floor. Until that day, just keep pulling. Pull everything inside, your knees together, shins together, on your chest. One more deep pull. Let everything go. Legs straight, lay on the ground, Savasana. The pulling and everything, that wind removing pose is good for your transverse colon, it's good for your body, it's good to cut off a little circulation to it, and then your knees, now they're getting all that fresh blood, all that air rushing back to that position, feeling nice and easy. Bring your feet together, arms together over your head, thumbs crossed, and you sit up. Double exhale, grab your toes, nose to your knees, breathe out. All right, sit up, come to your seated on your Japanese style or fixed firm. If you need to, you want to keep your knees together, you can open up your legs. If you can get your buttocks on the ground, then you can go back. If not, there's nothing wrong with just sitting here. About the worst I get. So, I can't put my butt on the floor either. So, wherever you can do it, Shannon's pretty good at getting all the way down there.
Oh, to go back. Yeah, you just...
But the key is keep your knees together. If not, don't worry. And Rick, that's perfect. That's where I get. As long as your airway is open, your back is straight, and you're doing what you can. Right? Yep. It's nice, peaceful, much better than camel. Camel always makes me go, oh my God. Back slowly the way you went into it. Feet, you're pushing down on your feet with your hands. Lay down, Savasana. Feet together, hands together over your head, thumbs crossing, sit up. Double exhale, grab your toes, lay flat on your belly facing me. Start off with cobra. So bring your arms or your hands about chest wide. Alright, good. When you push up, you're gonna use your whole body and just push. See if you can keep your belly down. If you can't, don't worry about it. Come up, belly button on the ground, look up, elbows back, chest back. The more you look up, the more that airway is open and the more you can breathe. I'm a big fan of breathing. Look up one more, push up, and come down. Left ear on the towel, look right. Locust. Bring your, if you can, palms together, elbows together underneath your body, palms down. Left leg flat on the ground, right leg lock it out and push it up. Imagine that you're aiming for a 45 degree up there while keeping your hips flat on the ground, chin on the ground. Slowly lock your other leg and go up. There you go. Nice. Bring your leg back down. See if you can bring your arms in a little bit closer. Knees together, ankles together, feet together. One solid cobra tail with your legs and bring both legs up. Lean forward with your body and stretch up with your back. Try to get your thighs and hips off the floor. Push, pull, push, and come down. Right ear down, face the left side. Arms at your side, bow pulling pose. Try to grab your 2 inches below your feet. Look forward. Your feet, your toes should be no more than 6 inches apart. And pull. Kick with your legs. You should be rolling forward and your legs should be coming up over your head. Thighs off the ground. Legs up, and come down. Savasana. Bring your arms at your shoulder width and push up into a high plank. Back feels good. Look up. You want to to the left, or you want to shift, whatever you want to do. Like Brandy says, if you close your eyes, no one can see you. I close my eyes through a lot of yoga. Walk your hands back. Feet planted on the ground. Grab your elbows, ragdoll. Shift to the left, shift to the right. Turn. Give yourself a little love. Whatever feels good. Bring your hands down back to the floor. Put your palms down in front of you. So like this, spacing, and step on your toes. You are actually, when you bring your heels off the floor, you are picking yourself up off the ground. So you are capable of picking your entire self up off the ground. Maybe it's only for a second, but that's all right. It's a good, we don't massage our feet or our hands enough. So it's a nice little stretch. Bring your hands out from underneath your toes. Bring them to your shins for a flat back. Go back down. Touch the ground. Slowly for a 10 count. Rise like a flower petal blooming. Each vertebrae feeling it as it comes up. Bring your arms up over your head. Nice stretch. And come back down. Flat back. Hands flat on the ground. Walk your hands back out into a high plank. Come to your knees into tabletop. Lay down on your feet into child's pose. Stretch your arms out. Drink water, be happy, you can lay on your back, whatever is comfortable for you.
Cushion or some extra mat, we can roll something up for you and give you a little support. When you're ready, just go ahead and close your eyes. Begin to draw your attention inward towards your heart. And notice how you're breathing. Where you're breathing, in your chest, or in your stomach, just notice. moving up to your legs, all the way up to your belly, into your heart, your throat, and the crown of your head, wiggling your fingers along the way. Bring back awareness into your breath. Slowly start to wake up your senses. Wiggle around a little bit. Move your head left and right. Maybe slowly, slowly, slowly start to open your eyes if you want to. And when you're ready, roll over to the right side or left side and lie there in a fetal position, in a little ball for a moment. And take a breath or two and then push yourself up to a seated position. Just sit comfortably. Your legs, your butt, whatever feels good. Rounded back into the earth again. Enjoy the breeze. Thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you for spending your time with us. It's always great to meet new people and visit with people that we've met. Thank you for your energy. Send it out into the world with these waves and our smiles and our hearts full of happiness. Look forward to seeing you all again. Thank you for being here. Namaste.
You like the shoulders better?
Kind of hard to say. You know, it's like, I don't know. I just can't stand on that flat leg.
That's right. I mean, like I said, you do what you can. Like, you know, 6 months ago, I couldn't bring my leg up. But, you know, I'm like, you know, and it just gets a little bit better. And I fall out 20 times in a minute. But, you know, I just keep trying. So I call, you won a whole week of free yoga. Whoa, okay.
Wow.
And I went into the hot yoga. It was a Bikram studio. And there was a guy there who looked like Frankenstein. He had scars everywhere. He looked about 35. And I usually am not rude, but when it was half a ton of it, I'm like, dude, like, what happened? Because when I was 35, I got in a car accident. He said he'd never walk again. And he said the first year he came, all he did was lay in the back. Second year started crying, third year, boom. And he's been doing it for 15 years. He looked 35, he goes, I'm 50. And I said, I want to look, if I look half as good as you, and that was sold. And the other thing, so I used to do search and rescue for the Air Force, and the course that we go through is really, really hard. And doing the hot yoga put me back in that mindset of like, ooh, I have to just keep breathing.
Yeah.
You know, I gotta lay down. But it gave me, so I'm like, if I can survive 90 minutes of this, I can raise kids on my own, I can do this, I can do a marathon, I can do anything I need to do, because I can do this for 90 minutes. So it kind of got me hooked. And then in December, they said, it was one of the teachers. So I started teacher training, and it's hard. Like, there's a whole, I'll show you. Well, one, there's 26 poses, but there's a whole dialogue of, and there's an hour's worth of words, and that's only like 15 minutes. And you have to memorize it verbatim. I like solo yoga, I like all stretching, just like scrunching or putting my knee in the air or cutting off my airway and just keep breathing.
I know.
Like we were talking about, like, you know, some couples go through walls, they spend the night life together. We've known each other for longer.
It's so bad.
And we kind of met at a Loud Love It concert. And
the universe kept us here.
Yeah, like the most randomest places. This is my first healthiest relationship.
She's gonna, like
from birth.
Like,
ever. Ever.
Not like you're both secure.
Well, it's like, it's just a good spell.
She's pretty smart.
And I just like it. It's nice to meet someone you just like.
Yeah.
You know? Just like him. It's a cool dude.
Hey guys, y'all stay and have some banana bread with us. I made it this afternoon.
Okay.
Wow.
How's that, bro?
Look at that.
That's my $15 Brad Steel. You ever see that Brad Steel on the internet?
No.
It's this company. They come out with all these big people advertise on them for their goods and stuff. And they're just really some good stuff. Some, you know, look at a thousand pieces of crap for one thing.
Yeah, right.
When they had that one thing, this was like $15.
Can't beat that.
No, and it was, and it's got this handy carrier.
And, which poses more difficult.
And it's got this thing that you can microwave
inside
there. I just
don't want to lay on my
there.
On my
Isn't that cool?
Perfect.
These right there. So we can socially eat banana bread at a distance.
Why don't I start this trend?
You're ready to squish the baby.
Not ready to squish it. It just feels like, I don't know how to explain it.
It's not comfortable.
You just feel it
right
like inside
you. I can't eat before I go to yoga. I'll be.
And it's hard.
Yeah.
I just, all I want to do is just lay there and cover up with that blanket I have.
She owns the union. Her name is Lisa. And she was Bikram's head teacher for years. And she did yoga. She did that yoga up until like the day before she gave birth, and then used all the breathing. She used that pranayama breathing, and she actually blew off all the medication from her epidural. So when they went to cut her for it, she felt so like and they're like, okay, stop.
Yeah.
But it's such a powerful, you know, what you can do.